Manny, I see you in the chat. I'm gonna give you a present today, okay? Obviously, like, you know, nothing of cash value, but, you know, we're not materialistic out here other than trying to buy my girl some titties at the age of, like, 35 when they start sagging. Two kids deep, them shits turn into fucking udders. But I know what you're gonna say in this stream. You're gonna be like, yo, did you hear that new Lil Pump snippet? And I'm not gonna lie, this shit low-key bumps, okay? Okay, look, you see this shit? Look, 5,000 views. I know Lil Pump is big. I posted this shit 2 hours ago, okay? You know, this page ain't that big compared to, like, Sofago, like 1,000, 1,800. That's something like a Cardi post would do, but listen. Okay, so it's hard to tell because, like, the 808 was clipping. But the thing is, look, again, the beats, I feel like he just figured out the beats situation. Okay, like his last one, what was the other Lil Pump music video? It was where he was on the ice thing. What's it called? A snowmobile, if you will. It was called, it wasn't First Off, was it? Okay, so he dropped another song called First Off. It was all of a sudden, look at that, 4 mil views. You know, you wouldn't expect that out of Lil Pump, considering, you know, he's kind of fallen off, but also he came back with a, I don't know if he'll ever hit the peak that he once did with Gucci Gang, just because I feel like that was a time in music where clout was more important than the quality of music. But I think we came back. It's like politics. You go super hard right with the president, you get Trump, and then super hard left. I mean, actually, Biden isn't that left, I don't think. But you get what I'm saying. You go back and forth. So we're going to continue this pendulum of going towards clout, and then we're gonna come back to quality of music. Right now, we just have to be in the quality of music. Actually, you could argue that some of the people, like, in the underground now, like, are just clouded and don't actually make good music. Personally, I like it, but you get what I'm saying. At the time, though, we liked Lil Pump's music. But anyway, I don't know if Lil Pump will ever reach, like, his old Gucci Gang success, just because that music video hit, like, what, a billion views? But, you know, I feel like he stepped up his game with the quality of music, hopefully, you know, or I wish that he had just done this years ago. What does fall off mean? Hella people have different ways of describing it. What does falling off mean? Falling off is essentially, it's almost like a feeling type thing, because you could be like Ugly God, where you fall off the face of the planet. But you kind of did it purposely. You, like, just stopped, or like Frank Ocean, or like whatever. You just stopped dropping music. So you were the cause of your own demise, and you did it purposely. Now, you could also be the cause of your own demise if you fall off in a negative sense, where, like, you're still trying to drop, almost like what Roddy Ricch is going through right now. You're trying to drop, you're doing the right things, but just the numbers ain't hitting anymore. The feeling around the fan base is just like, damn, what the fuck are you dropping, bro? So I don't think Lil Pump will ever, like, fully fall off. Like, there's a difference between Pump right now and Smoke Perp. Like, we hear this Pump snippet and we're like, yo, this, you know, He kind of did something. Whereas if we heard a Smoke Perp snippet, we're like, get this trash out of here. We ain't trying to hear this shit. People want Lil Pump to win, low key. Whereas Smoke Perp, people do not want him to win. That is the difference between falling off. And Lil Pump is, like, almost a mainstream celebrity at this point. Like, if anyone saw him, they may not remember any of his music or even listen to it ever. But they see the hair, and they're like, yo, that's Lil Pump. He's just a brand. It's like Lil Yachty. Roddy will never get the box numbers. Right. But he like tried to portray himself as this guy who could go rare, like Cardi. He was trying to be Cardi. I know we always refer to everything as Cardi, but nah, he was trying to be Cardi. Taking 3 years to drop, or however many years it was, 2 years, actually, 2019 to 2022, 2.5. So he's like Uzi. So he was trying to be rare, and then he dropped thinking that he was like, yo, this shit gonna go off. This shit gonna get 100K. Nope. 65K, you little bitch. My mom could literally shit out 65K. Nah, I'm playing. I would definitely not even come close to even 0K. But whereas Lil Pump, I don't know. I feel like he wasn't trying to be rare. He just kind of was doing his thing. He was just trying to get out of a label deal. He finessed his label like 3 times. He low-key independent right now, I feel like. Also, Perp was like biting Cardi and like biting other people. Pump is still being Pump. I think he tried some like emo rap shit down here. I think it was In Da Way. That shit was trash. What is this? He had episodes, like TV shows? Nah, but he was still Lil Pump or a Smoke Purr. Like, I just feel like when you're trying to be other people, it just goes down. He's bitten every single rapper. Comethazine, all of them. Not Pump, Perp. Flop is a weird word people throw around a bunch now. What exactly is a flop? Now, flop, I believe, is very similar to falling off in that... Huh. Okay. You can be a rapper, and of course, there's like a 3 to 5 year span where you're like so hot. And that's like a long extent for a rapper. Usually it's like a year, like Lil Pump, 2018 or whatever. Like he was already on his downward trajectory. But it's about like the comparison to where you were. But if you're a rapper who gracefully like just slowly goes down, people won't notice like the cliff. So when you fall off or when you flop, it's like you weren't prepared for it. You belly flopped when you jumped off of the diving board and just like you didn't gracefully dive into the water and fall off. No, you literally smacked your shit, your stomach on that. Everybody saw the splash. It wasn't graceful at all. So that's what it is. I think it's just the comparison between where you were and then sharply diving down and then you hit this all-time low. But if you're like, say, I don't know, like T-Pain. I love T-Pain, don't get me wrong, but you know, like he's not the most relevant rapper or R&B singer anymore, right? But he did have some hits. However, he's not out here trying to be like flexing on the gram and whatever, like being something that he's not. He's being graceful with his retirement from rap. Now he's a Twitch streamer doing his thing. You feel me? Yeah, flopping is not meeting expectations. Another way of like not fulfilling your expectations, or the comparison that people bring to you. But you probably said it better than me. Yeah, Perp even started to bite Yeet. Once you start doing shit that's not you, like, you know it's over.